Pay attention. This is how we get well. What we have is attitude, exercise, toxins, energy, microbiome, nutrition, and genetics. We're going to look at each of those briefly and then spend some time on nutrition. Are we a prisoner of our genes? No. Now, there's a pretty good chance I'm never going to play in the NFL or the NBA. The fact is there's certain limitations to your genes. However, people have a tendency to say, well, you know, six people in my family got cancer. I guess I'm going to get it. No. And so there are many what they call epigenetics or nutrigenomics, in which what we eat, our lifestyle, changes genetic upregulation and downregulation, turns switches on and off based upon what we put in our body. Dean Ornish was a cardiologist who got tired of doing bypass surgery in patients, and he looked at lifestyle. And he found that a plant-based diet, exercise, and meditation could reverse heart disease. And he said, I wonder if it'll work for cancer. So we tried it on indolent or slow-growing prostate cancer patients and found it worked. What they did is they took microarrays, a needle biopsy of slow-growing prostate cancer. They took the cells out, and they looked at the DNA, and then they gave them a lifestyle program and found within 3 months there were 500 measurable changes in the DNA based upon lifestyle. You're not a prisoner of your genes. You don't have to get cancer or heart disease or diabetes.